This is a stimulus update and daily news report. A lot of differing things going on right now with the eviction ban over as of Friday last week because of the Supreme Court ruling. A lot of Democrats are fuming over the inaction of Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer because they are not doing anything about it. But there are a few states that have extended the eviction moratorium. I'll let you know which states those are. We'll go over these two articles right here. What would a fourth $2,000 COVID stimulus check cost taxpayers? Concern over Delta and national debt, and the tax overhaul Democrats are pushing that could raise enough money for two $1,400 stimulus checks. I'll play you the latest video clip from Bernie Sanders, and then I'll answer the question you leave for me in the comments. Hope you're having a terrific Tuesday. If you appreciate these fact-based, fast-paced updates, hit the like button down below. And if you're curious where I'm at, I'll let you know later on in the video. And I apologize for any past technical difficulties. I wasn't able to upload a video over the weekend, and the video I filmed just couldn't go out in time. But I'll talk more about that later on. First, I want to give you some more important updates here. So Tropical Storm Ida leaves more than 1 million without power, one death confirmed so far. So this Ida has made landfall in Louisiana and has been ripping through since Sunday as a Category 4 with 150 mile per hour winds. And it did get downgraded to a tropical storm, but still causing a lot of damage with heavy rainfall, tornadoes, and potential severe flooding to parts of the south. East. It's really bad there, and my prayers and thoughts go out to all families, friends, anyone you know, and anyone living in that area. It's a really bad situation right now. Next, let's talk about what's going on with the eviction moratorium. So as of Friday last week, Supreme Court has ruled out that CDC eviction ban, meaning that evictions can happen now with the exception of a few states, which I'll go over in a moment. But it was supposed to go on until October 3rd, but it has been thrown out by the Supreme Court, and many Democrats saying that sitting on their hands, Democrats fume over inaction by Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer to extend the eviction ban. So about a month ago, this is when the eviction ban expired August 1st, and a lot of different Congress members were sleeping out on the Capitol overnight to try to get it extended. They were successful. They got it extended 60 days, but now it's been pretty much cut for half the time. The eviction ban is now over, and evictions can happen as of now. So a lot of people are unhappy that Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer are not doing anything about it. But at this point, with the Supreme Court ruling, there's almost nothing that can be done about it. Preliminary thoughts on this down in the comments below. Should the eviction ban be extended longer? Should it end now? So also regarding the eviction ban, so the national eviction ban is over, but renters still can't be forced out in these states. So there are a few states that have their own eviction ban rules. So the national eviction ban is no longer in effect after the Supreme Court struck down last week, yet a number of states renters are still entitled to protection. So which states are they? It says right here there are at least four states, and Washington, D.C. will continue to ban evictions. Illinois will do it until September 19th. California's ban will last through September 30th. New Jersey and D.C. will still curb the proceedings until January of 2022. And New Mexico also has an eviction moratorium in effect, and an expiration date has not yet been announced. So those are the four states plus Washington, D.C. that have extended the ban so far. But even in a lot of places that have extended it, there's still evictions going on. It's a very hard thing to curb right now. Because of landlords not getting paid for over a year in terms of rent. So let me know your thoughts on that. Should this be corrected? Should this play out as is? Let me know your thoughts on the eviction ban. Also, grocery prices continue to rise, and there's no end in sight. So according to this, it's saying food prices rose again last month by 0.7%, and that it said prices for groceries and other food prepared at home increased to 2.6%. So food prices are still going up and up. Doesn't look like it's ending anytime soon. And inflation doesn't seem as transitory as they predicted. They're saying hopefully in the fall that inflation will start to settle down a little bit. But as of now, inflation is continuing to rise. Let's go over this article right here. What would a fourth $2,000 COVID stimulus check cost taxpayers? Concerns over Delta and national debt. So what it's saying here in this article, basically going over the different costs of stimulus checks, what it would cost the taxpayers in terms of national debts, and will there be a stimulus check because of what's going on with the Delta variant rising. Let me know your thoughts on this. Then there's also this article that just came out too. The tax overhaul Democrats are pushing that could raise enough money for two $1,400 stimulus checks. So what it's saying here is one Democratic plan would overhaul how companies pay taxes on overseas profits. It could generate $800 billion or enough to finance two $1,400 stimulus checks. And Democrats may clash on taxes as they assemble a party line spending package. So basically, what it's saying here is that if they raise the corporate tax hikes on the wealthiest Americans, investors, and large companies, President Biden proposed a 28% corporate rate higher than the current 21% level. So if they could do that, raise enough money from taxes, it could be $800 billion that they could raise. And that's enough money for the federal government to finance two $1,400 stimulus checks, similar to the ones Americans received in the $1.9 trillion Biden stimulus law during the pandemic. So basically, from these tax new tax laws that'll happen, that'll just tax the wealthiest as well as corporations, it could raise $800 billion, which could be enough for two $1,400 stimulus checks with the current parameter. So basically, anyone making less than $75,000, each one of those, or this last round, the third stimulus check of $1,400, cost around $400 billion. But is this a good idea? Do you think that two more $1,400 stimulus checks is a good idea? Is one more good enough? Should the restrictions be higher? Should it go to more targeted, lower income people in terms of a fourth stimulus check? Let me know your thoughts on that down in the comments below. Just because it says here, though, I want to go back to this headline up here. So just because it says that they're raising enough money doesn't mean that they're going to give out two $1,400 stimulus checks. It's kind of a misleading headline. It's just basically saying they're able to raise $800 billion. But do you think they should use that money for stimulus checks? Let me know your thoughts on that down in the comments below. When it comes to the fourth stimulus check, the $2,000 per month to every American petition that's going on right now, so it is currently at 2,848,000 signatures on the change.org petition site. Then also we have Bernie Sanders here. So Bernie Sanders visits Detroit with Representative Tlaib to discuss floods and $3.5 trillion proposal. So Bernie Sanders is going on a little bit of a tour here, trying to push the $3.5 trillion budget resolution reconciliation bill, which has all of those stimulus provisions in it. So basically, over the weekend, he gave some talks basically promoting that. Here is a video clip that is a little off topic than the $3.5 trillion stimulus package, but basically talking about the needs of what needs to happen moving forward.
Something is quite wrong about the sense of priorities in this country.
While Democrats and Republicans and others may worry about the very wealthiest people in Congress, I'm not. Those are the people who've made out like bandits. The rich continue to get much richer. The poor continue to sleep out on the street.
In a time when millions of senior citizens and people with chronic problems cannot afford their prescription drugs, the pharmaceutical industry is enjoying record-breaking profits.
There is no housing crisis. There is a crisis in the federal government's relation to low and moderate income people.
As every working parent knows, childcare is extremely expensive. The rich have got to start paying their fair share of taxes. You can't just tax the middle class and the working class.
The root cause of the housing crisis in this nation is a system of priorities which says that we will give tax breaks to wealthy people, we will encourage the building of expensive condominiums, but we will damn well not put money into low and moderate income housing.
We are seeing all over America expensive housing being built because there are certain people who have enough money to buy expensive housing, and yet we're not seeing affordable housing being built.
The United States today has by far the highest rate of childhood poverty in the industrialized world.
Many, many of our senior citizens are having a very difficult time today paying for their health care needs despite Medicare and despite Medicaid.
Quality child care is so expensive that many low-income workers are spending a significant percentage of what they earn on child care.
We're really creating two nations, one for the very rich and one for the very poor.
Whether you agree with Bernie Sanders or not, you have to admit that he has been very consistent. You could see he's, you know, from years ago, decades ago, he's been saying basically the same thing as he's saying now. in terms of helping out the lowest income people in our country, as well as lowering pharmaceutical drug prices. Let me know your thoughts on that video clip down in the comments below. Next, I'm going to answer the questions you leave for me in the comments. Michelle Robertson asks, question, are they talking about another lockdown in December? As of now in the US, they're not really talking about another lockdown. I know in other countries, Australia, China, Vietnam, Philippines, they're having lockdowns, but in the US, they're trying to stay clear of a lockdown or even the mention of a lockdown. They're worried that that could cause a lot of panic to happen. So in the US, no lockdown in December or any lockdown mentioned as of yet. Michael Moreno Sr. asks, what about people on disability and all that, because I only get $800. So in the past video, I spoke about all the different proposals for Social Security increase. When it comes to disability, unfortunately, they've been left out. The only proposal was the one that President Biden campaigned on, which was the $200 per month to all Social Security recipients, which included the disability. So that's the only one where it would give an increase of an extra $200 per month. Besides that, there's no other programs that will help SSDI or anyone on disability Social Security recipients. Next question comes from Oma Snopas. What happened to the SNAP EBT increase? So SNAP is being increased permanently by 15% for everybody. That is official. So if you have SNAP, it's going to be a 15% increase for everybody. And then Shannon Bolden, what's up with Florida? Anything extended? Not really sure what you're talking about there in terms of anything extended in Florida. Next time, just maybe be a little more specific. Trying to think. I know they have the $1,000 thank you checks for teachers, first responders. I'm not sure of anything else being extended in Florida. Anyways, that is all the stimulus news I have for you today to hopefully cheer you up a bit. Here's my daughter Bella's tip of the day.
Hi guys, this is Bella. This is the tip of the day. I tell you the one thing I should do. When you feel something and you don't really feel good, then be grateful what you have. Be thankful. Because the next day I might not be there. So that's what I wanted to say. True or false?
Thank you so much for watching. So, I didn't get the chance to mention this in the past video, but we actually went away for a few days for Bella's birthday. We're currently in Florida. We saved up some money. We're staying at a hotel. Here's the view right from the balcony. It's a port, and this is the river, not the beach. But yeah, it's really nice here. Bella's having a great time for her birthday weekend slash week. And yeah, I'm gonna try my best to try to give you some more daily updates as more important news comes out. The only problem is the internet here is really, really bad. Usually at home, it takes maybe 3 minutes to upload a video to YouTube. Maybe because so many people are using the internet at this hotel or what, I don't know, just slow internet. It takes about 4 hours. So from 3 minutes to 4 hours, and then every time I would check on it, it would get interrupted. I would have to start over. So I'm gonna try my best to continue to upload these videos, but it may be sporadic over the next few days. Try to bear with me, and then next week everything will be back to normal. Anyways, if you want to check out any of my other videos, you could click up here from our other channels or down here for more stimulus updates, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, be safe, thank you for watching.